Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Boys and girls, today is our fiqh lesson, and our fiqh lesson is on the continuation of our sunnah ghusl. Remember last week we discussed the occasions when ghusl is sunnah, and there were four occasions. We discussed the first two, one being the Friday and the other one being the two Eids, and then we extended a little more explanation on those 2 days. Now, today, we're going to continue on point number 3, and that is to make a sunnah ghusl before wearing the ihram. So, boys and girls, what is the ihram? In order to perform umrah or hajj, a Muslim man and woman has to enter into ihram. So, without ihram, one's umrah and hajj cannot be performed. So, what is the ihram? It is a special clothing designed to wear to perform the hajj and umrah. Men and women's ihram are different. Men's ihram consists of the 2 sheets which you see in this picture, 2 sheets of white cloth that does not actually cover the entire body, only certain parts of the body. Then a woman, her ihram is to dress completely, fully covered, leaving her face and hands open. But a woman would wear her ordinary clothes, not anything special. But now, ghusl must be performed before wearing these clothes. And when ghusl is made, niyyah has to be made. Niyyah for wearing, putting on the ihram has to be made after the ghusl. So after the ghusl for putting on ihram, for going for hajj and umrah. Now we go to point number 4. Another occasion when the sunnah ghusl is made is for the haji, the hujjaj, the person who is performing hajj, and that is on the day of Arafah, and that is the second day of hajj. When he reaches on the plains of Arafah on the second day of hajj, the haji gathers here, they gather here from fajr until sunset, opening their hearts to Allah, making sincere dua, asking for forgiveness and for all their needs to be fulfilled. This is a very special day amongst the days of Hajj, and this is another special occasion where our beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam loved to make a sunnah ghusl. But if it is not possible due to all the crowds and it is difficult, then we should leave this sunnah ghusl out. Now, alhamdulillah, boys and girls, we have covered the sunnah occasions when ghusl is sunnah. And now, next week we will continue with our next lesson. But just a little reminder, please don't forget about your assessments. I will post the rubric and extra details later on again to remind you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.